What is up, guys? This is Max Square, and welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to be showing you the top 10 UI features in macOS Mojave. Now, just in case you missed my latest video or you weren't able to watch the full Apple keynote, I did publish a 8.5 minute or so summary of everything you need to know about WWDC, so I'll put a link to that here or here. It's this side. I got it. It's this one right here. Also, if this is your first time here, I make videos all about how to increase your productivity on your Mac, iPad, and iPhone. So if that's something you're into, consider subscribing down below. Now, let's jump into the video. So obviously, one of the biggest UI changes in the latest version of macOS is that we now have a dark mode. And guys, let me tell you, it is beautiful. I have been waiting for this for so long on Mac, and I think they did a really good job. Even though this is still in beta, obviously there's gonna be a couple bugs throughout the OS, but the UI is pretty clean. Every now and then the graphics will kind of glitch and you'll kind of see some of the light UI coming in, maybe on the borders or in the shadows of the apps. But overall, this looks really cool. Now I'm gonna go ahead and bundle up dark UI with dynamic desktop, which just basically is how the color scheme of the UI will change throughout the day. So if you have this set to light mode, it won't work on dark mode because if you're on dark mode, it's likely you just want it to stay that way. But if you just go to general, you go to light mode. Right now it's about afternoon, so it's gonna have a light UI throughout. You can see it's changed the desktop background. And so we've got a lighter picture here, but just to show you how this could work, if I set my time to something like 8 p.m., you'll see it gets a little bit darker. We're now seeing some sunset in the wallpaper. And if I go to something like 11 p.m., you can see we're back to the full on dark UI. So it actually works pretty well. They haven't just taken, you know, one photo in the morning and one at night and then just have you toggling between the two. It actually is a much more slower gradient between. And I would be really interested to see how they could integrate this with maybe third party apps or allow you to do this with any image. Maybe if you give it enough versions of a specific location or a photo, then it would just kind of do it on its own. But for right now, it works pretty well. Now at number two, we have a redesigned lock screen. So this is actually a little subtle, but basically it just means that the wallpaper isn't blurred anymore. It used to kind of blur out your wallpaper and just give you your profile picture, but the UI has kind of changed here. It's a little bit cleaner. So that's number two. Number three, and you may have already noticed this already, is that the menu bar can be set to hide automatically. So right now the menu bar isn't there, but if I just move my cursor to the top of the screen, it'll just drop right back down. Now you can disable this in settings if you just want it to always be there no matter what, but I think it's actually really nice, especially when you're working on a smaller screen like this 13-inch MacBook. You really want to maximize all of the screen real estate that you can. Now number four is taking a feature from iPad, and that is the recently used dock section. So if we take a look at my dock, you'll see that we have all of the default apps, but then we have two separators. Usually you just have one between the last app and the trash can, but we have another one here, and that's just showing the last apps that I've opened. But for example, if I opened up another app like Stocks, you can see it opens it in the recently used apps because it's not just gonna add it to your actual dock section. Once you close it, maybe you wanna open it again, you have it right there on the right side of the dock. At number five, we finally see a redesign for the Mac App Store. This is gonna make browsing through apps way easier. It has a very similar layout to that of iOS's new App Store. It's a lot easier to find apps, but you also have the Discover tab, which shows you posts and other different features that the Apple writers will show. And I think a lot of developers will find this to be really useful and helpful to them just because their apps have a better chance of being discovered. And like I mentioned in my recap video, there's a lot of really big apps coming to the App Store like Adobe CC and Microsoft 365. So I think this is a really big change for the App Store. Then number six is the revised quick look feature inside of Finder. So if we open this up, you can see it's pretty much the same, but now we have this markup feature we can enable, and then we can add, you know, annotations, we can add text, whatever it is you would normally use preview for, you can do right here in quick look. You don't have to open up another app. And when you're done, you can just hit done and it saved that file. You're good to go. And then number seven, we have a new view in Finder, and that is the gallery view. This is actually replacing the slideshow view, if you're familiar with that. And I wasn't a huge fan of that way of browsing files, but this is way cleaner, and I actually could consider using this. One thing I would recommend with this is if we open up Finder secondary preferences, you can make that thumbnail size a little bit smaller, but also show the file name because then you can see which documents are underneath the larger thumbnail when you're browsing through that. And number 8, you've probably already seen it at this point, and that is the expanded metadata on the side. So usually you would have to click on a file and hit Command I to bring up more info and then see all the metadata. But now Finder has added a new sidebar to view all of the information for a file. So for photos, this is perfect. I love this as a photographer. You can see all of your settings, the dimensions, right here in the sidebar. It just saves you a ton of time. And you'll notice at the bottom here, we also have some quick actions. So we can rotate it. We can pull up those markup features again. And Apple has said that you can actually add customizable actions here, something like from Automator. At this point, I haven't been able to figure out how to do so. They have a couple of other actions like creating a PDF and adding a password. But as of the first version for the developer preview, there is no option to do that. Number 9 is desktop stacks. Now, this is actually a really useful way to organize your desktop. If you have a ton of files, if it looks something like this, what you can do is go up to Finder, hit View, and select Use Stacks, and it'll basically just organize all of your files into specific categories and folders. Now, what's even cooler is you can actually decide which categories and folders it's going into. If we right-click anywhere on the desktop, you can select Group Stacks By, and by default it's kind. I think that's gonna be the most useful, but maybe if you're organizing things by tags, you can enable that option there. But then we also have a sort option, which will just show you how those are listed. So you can sort them by name, kind. I have it by date added, so I can access my most recent files. So they're really easy to use. You can just click on any stack and see all the files in there, get to the one you want, and then collapse it again, and you can keep your desktop nice and clean. And last but certainly not least, I have bundled together a couple of features for number 10 just because I didn't want to forget them, but they are a little minor. And first off, we have Safari introducing favicons or icons for tabs. You can just head over to the Safari preferences and enable those icons, and then you can see it updates across the tabs. So this just helps you distinguish which tab you're using, and if you have a ton of them open at once, it can just be really quickly to see which one you want to get to. Next up, we can now change the accent color throughout the entire UI. So if we just head over into the system preferences, this is where you can change your appearance from light to dark UI. And we've always been able to have this highlight color, but now we have an accent color. So by default, this is blue. It's the one we've come to know and love. But for example, if I set this to red, you can already see that the checkboxes and some of the drop-down menus have already selected that color. And if I go up to the menu bar, for example, and click on a menu, you can see that that highlight color is now red. So this is really cool for people like me who love to customize their desktop and mess around with the UI and themes and stuff like that. It would be cool if we could get a custom color. I can see why they wouldn't give you that option just because someone might pick a really weird color and then it's really hard to read the UI, but they've given you 7 or 8 different colors and they work pretty well. And now with the new update, you can now access emojis way easier. So for example, in Apple Mail, we now have a custom emoji menu. So you can just open that up, insert whatever emoji you want. Usually you would have to either go to another app that supported it, copied it and paste it. But now you can skip that whole process and just put them right in your emails. Now I know there's a feature I have not talked about at all, and that is the new screenshots update. You're supposed to be able to do video capture and also make some markup changes like you would on iOS, but unfortunately with the current developer preview, that is not available. But I'm sure by the time the public beta comes out, or maybe even in a later version of the developer preview, that will be available. So I'll definitely keep you guys updated on Twitter. So that has been the top 10 UI features for macOS Mojave. Obviously there's a lot of other features that are coming to the new macOS update, but I'm gonna be covering that in other videos. So if you wanna see those, make sure to stick around by hitting that subscribe button and the bell icon next to it so you can get notified when I upload those videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.